Jay has asked, what do you do if there is taper on the plastic gauge when measuring the rod bearings? Okay, well, this is one of the situations that gets a little bit tricky because there's nothing we personally can do. What we're going to need to do then is get our components back to our engine machine shop and have them actually correct that. So this may involve grinding the crankshaft to an undersized journal size, and then we would use a oversized bearing set to take up that clearance and start with a fresh journal finish. So it really depends on exactly how bad our taper is as to what we're going to do with it. Also depends as well on exactly what our application is. So a lot of the things that we could get away with in a relatively low power, low RPM application with absolutely no concern whatsoever, once we start stepping up to engines that are producing maybe 2, 3, 4 times what the factory power level was and exceeding the factory rev limit by significant margins, when we get to those sorts of engines, everything has to be absolutely perfect. And if anything is outside of our specification, it's going to need to be addressed.
That question was taken from one of our free live lessons. If you like free stuff and you're the type of guy who wants to expand your knowledge, click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson. You'll learn about performance engine building and EFI tuning, and you'll also have the chance to ask your own questions, which I'll be answering live. Remember, it's 100% free, so follow the link to claim your spot.